your question was related to what you have to learn in college, basically, to become or maybe successful in a type of this role. So for me, I think the utmost important thing is to know how to code, know how to develop products. So because if I don't have that information, I can't even think about planning for others. Like, I have to know what all goes into a development task, what all goes into like planning that development task or specifications of that whole project. So I have to know those skills. Second of all, I have to plan as well. Like, I have to know the skills of planning. And how do you learn planning? You can't, basically. But the way you procrastinate in your college, the way you delay everything in your college, that also teaches you something, like on how to plan your last day maybe, or how to plan your last night. So that is a type of thing you have to learn in college. What I think is 4 years are for to know how to become, or maybe to know how to learn things, not to learn coding or not to learn those basic theoretical. What they teach in 4 years in India is how to become a person who can learn everything, who can do anything, any task given to him can be completed by him. So I think the goal of every engineer should also be to learn that skill only. It should not be that DSL ko kar lenge, we'll learn this coding skill, so we'll get a job, we'll be successful, we'll do this in life. But you have to learn to be a engineer per se, as per an Indian definition, to do things, to be able to do at the last moment. So wo wali cheez, if you get it cleared in your 4 years, then you're good to go for life.
Yeah, so basically planning cannot be learned. So how do you even pitch for a job that is related to this field? Like, for example, if you are creating you're applying for a full stack developer job, you show them your projects. What do you show?
So I had to obviously pitch for this role, because when we were hired, we were just hired as IT people, or maybe people from India who have good IT skills and good like business skills or business leadership skills. And then we had these interviews where we had to pitch ourselves, like what we want to be in the company, what we want to have. We have a growth trajectory. And I think in every company these days, these processes are going on. They hire for a basic SD role, but then they do a certain type of interview to find out maybe this person is better in another job, or maybe he's not just meant for coding. Maybe he can lead that coding team as well directly. I have heard cases where interns have become project managers. So it's like a very great thing if you can crack that. What I think how I pitched was to tell that person that I have done my share of coding in college. I have done my share of development in college. I've led my share of teams in college. So you can trust me on that I can be on that level. Secondly, I don't just want to code in the back of a computer. And I just don't want to get commands from my senior that I have to code this today, I have to code this today. But be able to plan it maybe, and be able to put my ideas through it, or give my input at every aspect of it. And they understood it as well, like I can help in planning in that sense. So I think that's where I pitched it the correct way maybe.
Yeah. In your college, you have cracked this internship for MHRD's AICTE, that is All India Council for Technical Education. You're a trainee and the internship part.
Trainee, it's not a trainee. It's like a being a member of a committee or a team which tells MHRD about the college, or maybe like makes a communication between the two. It's not type of an internship.
Can you talk a bit about that? Even how you got in or got onto that community, or what you did in it.
So it's related to the part of the internal quality assurance cell. So every college has an internal quality assurance cell. Maybe it's not a big team in some colleges. Maybe it's not given that much attention in every college, but it's an important role. Like there, it's like a team where you can put your feedbacks. It's a team where all the certification type of things like NAC accreditations, or maybe all those other NBA approvals are gone through, or maybe a college society file at the end is given to the IQAC to check again what may be the like benefit of it or something like that. So for that, they have to communicate with all the ministries, and for every like annual reports and everything they have to communicate to every department of college, to every ministry, every, maybe the assembly is all also like DT was a state university. So we had to communicate with the assembly level as well. So there they added us to this members team where we can like communicate with them and directly tell them what's happening in the college.
That's interesting. So how did you crack this job? Was it an on-campus interviews or was it you went outside?
So it was just in DTO, we have a USIP type of thing where students can intern in college for various menial tasks and administrative help, like because professors are not that great in technology, maybe in studying, maybe in teaching they are very great, but when it comes to technology and using it for the helpfulness of the university and making the university at a better scale or maybe improving their ranks, they're not that good. So for that, they hire students like us and give us very minimal $2,500 per month and ask us to help the professors in various departments. It may be IQAC, maybe maybe the student development, dean, hostel office, international affairs office, library, maybe like, I know some of the people created an app as per a part of USIP in the library, something like those. So I interviewed for that and I had a senior who was in IQAC. So he recommended that I should join this team and it would be helpful for me.
Yeah. And the next question is, how did you land this job straight away in Tokyo? How did that happen?
So it was an on-campus offer, obviously. So like when it came to our like college, so we knew that it was like a top offer because it had that package thing, that it has a highest package or maybe a big number added to it. But a lot of people were skeptical because of being in Tokyo, being very around COVID, like it was the COVID period which was just starting. So I got my placement in and I think 9th March or 3rd March, and just after I think 20 days the lockdown started. So there were a lot of areas where like people were very scared, but at that time people didn't knew about the lockdown thing, so they were not very scared about international offers. But like Tokyo and Japanese and everything, it's a little bit scary. But I just wanted to give it up as a challenge for me to clear those rounds and like maybe just try what an interviewing for an international placement might be like. And that's where I fell in love with their whole process. And then how I saw that they're not checking coding in interviews, because their whole ideology was that I can't check a person's coding skills with 3 questions. That's basically absurd. Like you can just mug up 300 questions and give me the answer, and that's useless for me. You can't even code if you just mug up 300 questions. So their ideology was very perfect and matching with my own ideology, and that was where I felt great. And they were like hiring as a business leader, maybe for a coding role, like most of the people I came with are in e-commerce, maybe the back end, front end, are in coding roles. I am not in that. But they hired as a business leader, not as a coding person. Their whole ideology was, okay, you can learn these skills. Coding can be learned in a very few days. In the training, you can learn. But you have to learn a lot of other skills which take time, which take maybe 4 or 5 years to learn. Maybe the speaking skills, maybe the attitude, maybe finding good ways to solve a problem. You can say shortcuts to like add to that word, but finding the better solution every time. So I remember every time whenever a question comes around the interviews of this company, I remember a very basic question. They asked us to multiply 69 into 49, something like this. Mm-hmm. And the answer was pretty simple to calculate. And you had a pen and paper. And they selected people who multiplied using that 100 minus 1 into that whole formula. And then there were people who calculated it directly multiplying. Yeah. So they rejected those people who directly calculated, because like their whole ideology was, if he's just hardworking, we don't want him. But he should find a faster, easier,
smarter way. Work. Yeah,
and at that moment of time, like smart work, and at that moment, that was their whole idea there. And it was an on-campus offer, so I can't like give a lot of credit to myself for finding this job.
Yeah,
but like getting onto that opportunity and clearing those interviews was a tough thing. Like I can tell now, because they didn't check coding, they didn't check your theory of database or primary key or other things which are very easy to mug up, but they checked the person, how he was.